We have already shown some of the simulation enhancements for 2021 on the main stage, but now I'll go into some of these in more detail while also covering other improvements new to 2021. The enhancements are aimed at improving performance and accuracy, whilst also streamlining the process to give users the greatest chance of a successful simulation first time. To validate how this corner mount assembly will perform, fixtures and loads are created. To reduce the calculation requirements, the hardware components are set to use a draft quality mesh. When meshing components, it can be difficult to capture the exact curvature of curved surfaces, especially when using a coarse or draft quality mesh. With SOLIDWORKS Simulation 2021, the software automatically calculates geometry correction terms to improve the representation of cylindrical, spherical, and conical surfaces. The geometry correction results in more accurate simulation results for these curved surfaces. We will use the blended curvature-based mesher, which now benefits from multi-core processing for simulation professional and premium users, and can now also be specified as the default mesher within the simulation options if desired. The model takes around 12 seconds to mesh, which we will compare to 2020 shortly. The default solver choice has also been optimized to select the best solver based on the number of equations, load cases, mesh type, geometric features, contact and connector features, as well as available system memory. Improvements have been made to many of the solvers to give faster and more accurate results. For example, the Intel Direct Spar solver can now handle linear static and non-linear studies with more than 4 million equations. And for simulation professional and premium users, the FFE Plus Iterative solver is improved by using parallel multi-core processing to calculate stiffness for surface-to-surface contact elements. Solution time is faster and most apparent for large models with many contact elements. These results look good. Experienced users will recognize the terminology updates throughout, which makes SOLIDWORKS Simulation more consistent with conventional industry terminology. Contacts generally are now referred to as interactions. No penetration contact is now known as contact, and allow penetration is simply known as free. These changes follow through to other tools such as the interaction viewer, which was formerly known as the contact visualization plot. New default properties for bonded interactions specify gap regions to automatically make your simulation more robust, even with slightly imperfect geometries. For example, with this new property, clearances between the bolt, nut, and plate are automatically recognized and treated, saving you from inaccurate results and time spent troubleshooting the study. In SOLIDWORKS Simulation 2020, independent meshes were generated by default to make it easier and faster to mesh large and complex assemblies. In 2021, further changes have been made to improve the accuracy of the bonded formulation within static frequency and buckling studies to understand any gaps or small interferences between independent meshes, even though the actual geometries have no clearances. A typical example is when using shell elements, the gap is due to shell thickness. To check the quality of the mesh, a new diagnostics tool is available. The mesh is actually very good quality, so we will have to reduce the ratio to display anything. The worst elements are now automatically isolated, making them quick and easier to find. And the mesh helper can also be used to automate the mesh refinement if necessary. Switching back to 2020, using the same mesh took nearly a minute longer than 2021. Also, whilst it could easily be resolved, the default settings have not picked up on the clearance on the bolt, allowing it to pass freely through the bracket. Looking at another example, we can see that these two components start off with a small gap between them. We would always recommend closing this gap before applying the load, as otherwise we may get unpredictable results as we have here. Back in 2021, we now have some default interaction settings which will help us overcome this situation. The first setting caters for small gaps when using bonded interaction, which we saw in the previous example. The next settings will consider contact for elements within 10% of the overall model size, where previously we would have had to create local interactions between pairs of entities. This next option helps stabilize small gaps when using contact. So now we could simply switch the global interaction to contact, and the default values will identify faces within a set distance to consider contact, and also apply stabilization to help resolve areas which start with a small gap. we can see the area that has been detected using the interaction viewer, which combined with the contact stabilization gives us a fast, simple and accurate solution. Of course, it is still possible to define local interaction specifications, which also take advantage of contact stabilization and gap range specifications. Here you will notice additional terminology changes for contact offset, which was formerly known as gap clearance, and the new ability to swap source and target sets with the click of a button. Moving on to some of the other improvements, the simulation evaluator is enhanced to flag study definitions related to friction coefficients greater than 0.2, warning users of possible convergence issues. It also flags materials with invalid Poisson's ratios larger than 0.5 for linear static studies. Listing pin connector loads at pin joints is more accurate for shear forces and bending moments, now that their directional vector is defined at each joint individually. SOLIDWORKS Simulation 2021 enhancements demonstrate real-world user benefits, making it easier and faster than ever for SOLIDWORKS users to get accurate simulation results.